On Friday, the 30th of December 2022, Makerere University Convocation had an annual general meeting where the elections of new leadership were supposed to be taking place. And they did take place indeed, but were mad with chaos after the current leadership failed to agree with some candidates in the race about the modalities of the election. We sit down with the winner of the chairperson of the convocation to speak to us about this. Welcome, George. Straight to the point, what constitutes the convocation?
Yeah, the convocation is an association of staff and alumni. Alumni being the people who studied from Makerere University.
The convocation AGM, where that election took place, is always a quiet affair out of the public eye. Why was it very loud this time round? Why was it a heated race? And what are you fighting for?
To begin with, your concern is also our concern. The convocation has indeed been a sleeping giant. People who have studied from Makerere, even staff themselves, most especially the support staff, did not know about the convocation.
To which they are members?
To which they are members. We came out strongly to advertise it through social media, reaching out to our friends, and I think that's why people were responding positively. And going forward, we are not going to stop there.
After nomination, 7 out of the 9 candidates that were nominated came out of the race, and only you and Otim remained in the race. Why did you stay in the race? Didn't you see the irregularities your fellow contestants were raising, or you did not care about them?
For us, we had mobilized our people. We had already informed them that the voting was going to take place this year. An advert which was made by the executive came out in November stating the date. It is the creation of those members who are claiming right now, who came in late. It is the chaos is a creation by those members. So it is not our problem that people are not ready.
You are said to have been Dr. Tango Doi's choice. And in fact, his son, Collins Tanga, was on your campaign team and was also part of the race of publicity secretary. Do you feel that you were favored by Dr. Tango Doi?
What do you call favoring me? The issue is about mobilization. Did Tango Doi, Dr. Tango Doi, carry supporters to my side? If you are on the ground, Team George had 90% of the supporters. So I don't buy into that whole of people saying, because I know Tango Doi, I have been in that university for a very long time. I know every member of staff. Tango Doi was a member of staff in the university, and we worked closely. So finding me in a race, I don't think he would become a stranger to me because I'm contesting. Secondly, his son, Collins, has been my gango, has been my friend for a very long time. And we started planning this thing 2 years ago.
Some aggrieved candidates are going to court, and you will be taking leadership in April 2023. How do you plan to lead amidst such challenges?
You know, when I was doing my MBA, I was taught by my lecturers that you can turn actually a challenge into an opportunity. To begin with, I don't think it is right for our colleagues to go to court. And the convocation is not a monopoly of us who have become leaders. It is a convocation of all members, the alumni who have studied from Makerere University. So we are going to engage them. And we have already started engaging them. Some of them who are actually, they have started, like for example, we have talked to Ezra Byakutangaza, who was part of it. We have talked to Afande Muchunguzi. We have talked, whereas others are still insisting. But I want to believe that in the near future, some of them will be convinced to join us.
George here with me will be turning a challenge into an opportunity to lead the convocation come April 2023.